Hello friends, welcome to GYAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and currently we have started an MCQ series of environment and ecology, and we are on the lecture number 21 of this series. Already 20 lectures have been covered. If you want to see those previous lectures, you can go into the playlist of my channel which I have created specially for this purpose, and you can see all the previous videos. Friends, we have started this video series 20 days back, and we will continue this MCQ series till 31st May 2019. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC IAS. So we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So daily 5 questions will be covered. So in a way you will be approximately covering 1100 to 1200 questions of environment and ecology only. So you can see that if you are going to practice this much number of questions, how much confident you can be in your prelims exam regarding this topic. So friends, it is not the case that we will cover only environment and ecology. We will cover the other topics as well, like history, polity, geography, economy, art and culture, and current affairs, and all those other topics which are left. So actually we are a little bit busy these days, so we will start the series of other subjects as well from December onwards. So but now we are covering only environment and ecology. So let's start our discussion, friends. Lecture number 21. So we in this lecture, the first question is related to the Nokrek National Park is located in. So the options given are the West Garo Hills, the East Khasi Hills, the Janthia Hills, the West Khasi Hills. So friends, the Nokrek National Park, if you have read about it, then it is located in West Garo Hills. So basically it is in Meghalaya, and Nokrek is the highest peak in the Garo Hills. So there is the national park located, that is the Nokrek National Park. So option A is correct, Western Garo Hills. So it is also a biosphere reserve, and it is a national park located from 2 kilometers from the West Garo, from Tura Peak in West Garo Hills in district of Meghalaya. So it is in the World Network of Biosphere Reserves of UNESCO. So you can see there are three important, and it is also a hotspot of biodiversity. So you can see there are four important things that are associated with it. That's why it becomes important. So the location of Nokrek National Biosphere Reserve or National Park, you must know it. So why it is important? Because it is also a national park, it is also a biosphere reserve, it is under the World Network of Biospheres declared by UNESCO, it is also a hotspot of biodiversity. So please remember it, that Nokrek Biosphere National Park is in Meghalaya. So next comes the second question, the mangroves help in stabilizing the coastline and preventing the erosion from waves and storms. How do they do it? So the mangroves, you might have heard about, they are basically the plants that grow in saline conditions where the fresh water and the ocean water meets. So basically they are found in the ecotone zone. So here is a like kind of terrestrial ecosystem, and here if there is a marine ecosystem, then in this region you will find mangroves. If you have seen the map of India, then in this region are the mangroves, the Sundarbans. So basically this is an ecotone between the terrestrial ecosystem and the marine ecosystem. So the mangroves found here are in high intensity. So they kind of help in stabilizing the coastline, and they prevent the erosion from waves and storms that come from the ocean. So what is the reason behind this, and how do they do it? So for first option is the short height of mangroves slow down tides, hence coastal erosion. The B option is the dense roots of mangroves trap sediments flowing down rivers and off the land, which helps in prevention of erosion. The C option is leaves of mangroves thrive on excess water and help maintaining normal water levels. The last option is none of them. So you have to choose the correct option. Friends, if you have seen the structure of mangroves, then you can easily mark this answer. So here the option B is correct. Actually, mangroves, these plants, they thrive in saline water, and they have roots that are very dense. So these dense roots actually trap the sediments that comes from rivers. So they kind of stabilize the coastline and also prevent the erosion by trapping the sediment and soil in their roots. So So this is how they do this. So here is an I have included a pic. So there is no need of explanation here. You can see that this is a tree of mangrove and you can see its roots. So they are basically its root. So basically you can see that they have very high dense roots. So these roots will obviously trap the sediments or soil. So it will not let them go off by the water or any other process. So this is all about your second question. Next is your third question. Which of the following is the negative effect of forest fire? So friends, you might have heard about forest fires, the repeated forest fires that happen in forest in summers. It might be it might be natural, it might be man-made, but the reasons can be any about behind the forest fires. So we have to analyze the negative effects of forest fires. The first statement is they increase the probability of further burning in subsequent years. Second option is fires can be followed by insect colonization and infestation. The third is the replacement of vast areas of forest with pyrophytic grasslands results in loss of biodiversity. The fourth statement is smoke from fires can significantly reduce photosynthetic activity. So friends, we have to choose the correct option. So here in the options given below, the D option is correct. That is, all statements are correct. So how all statements are correct? Let me explain you. Friends, when forest fires take place, the trees, they burn. So kind of their debris falls on the soil. The soil becomes bare. For example, earlier if there are much trees in the absence of forest fire, so here it will be this will be the canopy of tree, and this will be the canopy of tree, and this is, for example, ground. Sorry for drawing, friends. My drawing is not much good, so that's why you have to adjust with it. So if there are forest fires, then these trees will kind of they will be eliminated from here, and this soil, the grasses will become the soil will become bare. So the species that are residing below their canopy will become bare, and they will and also the debris will be it will kind of lead to dry conditions. The sunlight will fall directly on the ground species, so it will dry them. Also, there will be immense fuel for the heat to further for the forest fire to further take place, because the debris of the dried plants will fall over the ground that were earlier burnt in the forest fire. So obviously this will increase the probability of burning in subsequent years. So second statement is fires can be followed by insect colonization. Yes friends, insect colonization takes place, new species comes, and infestation takes place. Third is the replacement of vast areas of forest with pyrophytic grasslands. Yes friends, it is true, when trees burn again and again by the repeated forest fires, the trees get eliminated and only the grasses stay there. So that will be pyrophytic grasses. Pyrophytic grasses are those that are resistant to fire. So only the grasses will be there. It will con This land will then further ultimately convert into grassland, and this will result in loss of biodiversity. Yes friends, it is the case. If in a grassland the biodiversity is much less as compared to in the areas which are forest. So you can see that in forest there are multiple trees, and they do the process of photosynthesis and provide food to various organisms, as well as they provide shelter to various organisms. If the forest is converted into grassland, then ultimately the shelter, the habitat of various organisms will be lost, the food will be lost, so obviously the biodiversity will be reduced. Next is the fourth. Yes friends, this is also true. When the fire takes place, there is a smoke that is released, and this smoke settles on the leaves of the other plants that are not burned in the forest fires. And when this smoke settles, this reduces the photosynthetic activity. Also friends, smoke reduces the penetration of sunlight. So when the penetration of sunlight reduces, then obviously photosynthetic activity will reduce, because photosynthesis depend upon the sunlight to come. So all the options are correct. So this is all about your question. Third question, I have already explained to you it in detail, all the reasons. About further reading, if you want to read it, you can read them in PDF form, which I will provide you. Next is the fourth question, the Chipko movement was launched against. So friends, it is very easy question. You might have read it in your school years, that what was Chipko movement. It was basically for the environmental conservation, and if we go into the detail, then it was for the conservation of forests. So kind of the local village communities, what they did, they went and hugged the plants. So that the contractors may not will not be the contractors are not able to cut these forests. So basically, this movement was started by Sundarlal Bahuguna. Please note that it is important. So it can be asked. So basically, it was a movement of 1970s. It was an organized resistance to destruction of forests. So it came to be known as the Chipko movement. Basically, it means to embrace the name of the movement comes from the embrace. So it was kind of you. If you understand Hindi, then chipkana is kind of two trees. Then hugging of the trees. This was the basically Chipko movement, and this movement was founder of this movement was Sundarlal Bahuguna. Basically, it was a non-violent protest, and it became a precedent, a kind of example of non-violent protest which started in India for the world to follow in for the conservation of environment or for the conservation of forests. Next is the last question of today, the mangrove forests. About the mangrove forest, let's see it. The mangrove forests have reached a critical stage of decline in many parts of the world. So, which of these have caused the gravest threat to mangroves? So, basically, mangrove, I have already told you that mangrove forests are kind of they are found in ecotone region where the terrestrial and submarine ecosystem meets. So, they are under now threat. They are under critical stage of decline. So, what are the possible reasons for the declining? The first is destruction of coral reefs. The second statement is freshwater diversion away from seas and oceans due to hydraulic structures. So friends, what is the reason? Is the option correct? Is both statements are correct. So the option correct is C. So friends, why these both statements are correct? Because friends, if you have read about coral reefs, they are found in the seas and they are not found in not in much depth, but they are found near the coastline. So for example, here is India, then coral reefs could be found here or here. So here they can be found also here or along the coastline. So basically, if you see the Sundarbans are in this region. So they are mangrove forests. So if the coral reefs are there, coral reefs, what they do, they act as a first line of defense against the high energy waves that come from the ocean or the high energy kind of waves that come from the ocean. So if the coral reefs are they are removed, they get devastated, then ultimately there will be no first line of defense, and these strong waves will ultimately strike the mangroves forest. So they will directly face the brunt of these high energy waves. So that's why there is a destruction of also the mangrove forest due to destruction of coral reefs, because their first line of defense gets eliminated. Second of statement, why it is correct, friends? Because for example, when the water comes from the when the rivers come from the Himalayas or for example from any source from mountains, they bring lot of sediment, and they here kind of deposit sediment. And said when the sediment is deposited here, they basically what happens, the change in salinity takes place. If we construct the hydraulic structures, for example, we construct the dams or any other structure, then this will they will not bring not bring much of water. So when their diversion takes place, the changes in salinity level takes place. The fresh water which comes here. So basically, friends, every living organism that lives in an appropriate range, that is favorable for it. So mangroves, though they are adaptable to saline water, but they are not much adaptable. So that is, they can much they can cannot face much stress of salinity. So if there is water diversion, that is fresh water that is coming from mountains, it is diverted due to dams or other hydraulic structures, then it will not come here. Then obviously, what will happen? The coastal water will continue to come into this region. So ultimately, the salinity will increase, because you know that the ocean water is saline. So the salinity will increase, and this will kind of exceed the tolerant capacity of the mangroves. And so due to this reason, the mangrove forests have reached a critical stage of decline. So both 1 and 2 are correct. So this is all about your today's lecture, and I have already explained to you in detail what are these. So oil pollution is also one of the threat, and it can smother mangrove roots.